हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, एम एम शेषाचारी, लेक्चर इन केमिस्ट्री, डॉक्टर अंबेडकर जूनियर कॉलेज, बागलिंगमपल्ली। वी स्टार्टेड द फर्स्ट ईयर ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री, द जनरल इंट्रोडक्शन, नेमिंग ऑफ ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड्स, आईयूपीएसी नेम्स, सम ऑफ द प्रैक्टिस वी हैव कंप्लीटेड, and alkenes, the first topic alkenes also completed. The next topic alkenes, today we are going to discuss about the alkenes, their methods of preparation, properties, naming, and all those alkenes we'll discuss in the today's class. Now alkenes generally known as olefins. Alkanes are generally known as paraffins. In the last class, I have given why alkanes are paraffins means alkanes are least reactive towards the chemical reaction. So they are said to be paraffins. Now alkenes. Alkenes are not more reactive. Alkenes and their halogenated compounds are oily. Oily fins, they are oily substances, their compounds are oily, that's why oily fins. Alkenes, halogenated alkenes are oily substances, the products of halogenated compounds of alkenes are oily substances, so they are said to be oily fins. The general formula CnH2n, the general formula of alkenes is CnH2n. Let us go to the naming of alkenes. In naming of any all carbon compounds, first of all we have to go to the root word. Next we have to go to the primary suffix. Next we have to go to the secondary suffix. Here no functional group, so only primary suffix, root word. Now let us take the first example, CH2 double bond CH2. Number of carbons 2. Eth. Double bond is there, ene. The name of this compound is ethene. Common name ethylene. Commercially, it is named as ethylene. Ethylene is a usage name, not IUPAC name. According to IUPAC system, ethene. The next molecule, let us take another molecule. Number of carbons 1, 2, 3. Root word pro. Double bond is there, ene. That ene is there on the first carbon. If you write the double bond, this side also will get the same. That's why we have to write propene, that's all. Propene. Now the other molecule, you have taken 4 carbons containing alkene. Now number of carbons 4. Root word is bute. Double bond is there, ene. The position of ene on first carbon. So, the name of this one is 1-butene or bute-1-ene. Bute-1-ene. Let us take the same 4 carbons containing alkene. See that. Here the double bond is there on second carbon. Bute-2-ene. It is named as bute-2-ene. 2-butene. So like this, we have to give the names of alkenes. Alkenes are olefins, oily compounds. Their halogenated compounds are oily, so they are said to be oily forms. Olefins. Now let us go to the preparations of alkenes. How to prepare alkenes? Commercially, large quantity of alkenes are manufactured from the dehydrohalogenation. Dehydration. Dehydrohalogenation of alkyl halides. Dehydration of alcohols. addition of hydrogen on alkyne. So these are the methods for the manufacture of alkene. Now let us take the first one. Dehydrohalogenation. D means removal. Hydro means hydrogen. Halo means halogen. So the removal of hydrogen and halogen from molecule is said to be dehydrohalogenation. The removal of hydrogen and halogen from a molecule is said to be dehydrohalogenation. So what is the reagent for dehydrohalogenation means? Alcoholic potassium hydroxide, alcoholic sodium hydroxide. Alcohol, potassium hydroxide is to be dissolved in alcohol, and that is said to be alcoholic potassium hydroxide. Otherwise, sodium hydroxide is to be dissolved in alcohol, and that is said to be alcoholic sodium hydroxide. And the role of alcoholic potassium hydroxide removes the hydrogen and halogen. So it's a dehydrohalogenating agent. It removes, it cuts off the hydrogen, it cuts off the halogen from a molecule. So it is said to be dehydrohalogenating agent. Now let us take example. It is in a chloroethane. Chloroethane. Generally, common name ethyl chloride. Ethyl chloride, chloroethane. According to IPAC system, chloroethane. Commercially known as ethyl chloride. So addition of the alcoholic potassium hydroxide it removes, it cuts hydrogen and halogen, and a double bond is formed between the carbon and carbon. Now it is like ethylene. Ethylene can be prepared. Ethylene can be obtained. Ethylene can be produced by the action of alcoholic potassium hydroxide. So see that the role of this one, it is cutting off hydrogen and halogen. Instead of this, we can take sodium hydroxide. Alcoholic sodium hydroxide also have same function. So alcoholic potassium hydroxide cuts off the hydrogen and halogen. So that's why it can be used for dehydrohalogenating agent. Alkene la tayari. Alkene lanu tayar cheyadaniki mottamodati vidhanam dehydrohalogenikaranamu. Dehydrohalogenikaranam. Hydrogen nu halogen nu tolaginchadanne dehydrohalogenikarana cheriya antaru. దానికి ఒక ఉదాహరణ తీసుకుందాం మనం. ఈథైల్ క్లోరైడ్, క్లోరోఈథేన్. క్లోరోఈథేన్ ను ఆల్కహాల్ లో కరిగించిన పొటాషియం హైడ్రాక్సైడ్ కలిపినప్పుడు ఈ ఆల్కహాల్ లో కరిగించిన పొటాషియం హైడ్రాక్సైడ్ హైడ్రోజన్ ను క్లోరిన్ ను హాలోజన్ రెండింటిని కట్ చేస్తున్నారు. కాబట్టి మనకేమొస్తుంది? ఎథిలిన్. తర్వాత ఉప ఉత్పన్నాలు కేసిఎల్ మరియు నీరు. కాబట్టి ఆల్కహాల్ లో కరిగించిన పొటాషియం హైడ్రాక్సైడ్ ను ఆల్కైల్ హాలైడ్ పై కలిపినప్పుడు అన్ని కూడా మనకు ఆల్కీన్స్ ఏర్పడతాయి అన్నమాట ఇది ఒక విధానం ఇక రెండో విధానం కెలిపోదాం డిహైడ్రేషన్ తెలుగులో నిర్జలీకరణ చర్య నిర్జలీకరణం జలాన్ని తొలగించడాన్నే నిర్జలీకరణం అంటారు డిహైడ్రేషన్ హైడ్రేషన్ మీన్స్ అడిషన్ ఆఫ్ వాటర్ డిహైడ్రేషన్ మీన్స్ రిమూవల్ ఆఫ్ వాటర్ సో డిహైడ్రేషన్ ఆఫ్ ఆల్కహాల్స్ dehydration of alcohol leads to form alkenes alkenes can also prepared by the dehydration of alcohols alkenes can also be prepared by dehydration of alcohols dehydration for dehydration what are the reagents used for dehydration concentrated sulfuric acid The role of concentrated sulfuric acid is removes the water from any compound dehydrating agent. Dehydrating agent, the chemical that removes the water from the molecules are said to be dehydrating agent. Now the concentrated sulfuric acid is dehydrating agent. Now let us take alcohols. Ethanol, ethyl alcohol, is to be heated with concentrated sulfuric acid at 170 degrees centigrade. Concentrated sulfuric acid is always acts as a dehydrating agent. See that it is an ethyl alcohol, CH3CH2OH. Addition of sulfuric acid. Concentrated sulfuric acid and heated at 170, it cuts up the hydrogen and hydroxide, and it gives ethylene. So, like this, ethylene can be prepared. Ethylene can be prepared by the action of concentrated sulfuric acid on ethyl alcohol. For getting the propene, we have to take propyl alcohol. So all alcohols, by the action of concentrated sulfuric acid at 170 degrees centigrade, they give alkenes. So alkenes can be obtained by the action of concentrated sulfuric acid on alcohols. So this is the second method of preparation. So these are the important methods of preparation of alkenes. Hydrogenation, not hydration, hydrogenation. Addition of hydrogen is said to be hydrogenation. Hydrogenation of alkynes gives alkene. Not complete hydrogenation, partial hydrogenation of alkene. partial hydrogenation of alkenes gives the alkyne. Alkynes gives the alkene. Partial hydrogenation of alkynes, triple bonded compounds, gives alkene. Partial hydrogenating agent. What is the partial hydrogenating agent? The partial hydrogenating agent is Lindler's catalyst. Lindler's catalyst. It helps only in the addition of one mole of hydrogen. Further hydrogenation cannot be done. ఒక హైడ్రోజన్ మాలిక్యూల్ మాత్రమే కలపడానికి సహాయం చేస్తుంది. ఆ తర్వాత ఇంకా ఫర్దర్గా హైడ్రోజన్ కలపడానికి వీలు లేకుండా చేస్తుంది. దాన్నే లిండ్లర్స్ క్యాటలిస్ట్ అంట. సో వాట్ ఇస్ ద లిండ్లర్స్ క్యాటలిస్ట్ మీన్స్ పెలాడియం బేరియం సల్ఫైడ్ ఇన్ బాయిలింగ్ జైలీన్ is the Lindler's catalyst. So in the presence of this, alkynes undergo only one addition of only one mole of hydrogen. Example, let us take an example, acetylene. Otherwise let us take ethyne. There are two pi bonds, totally triple bond is there. If you add hydrogen, and both the double bonds will undergo addition, finally we will get an ethene. Instead of that, only one pi bond is to be added. So what is the reagent is to be taken? Palladium barium sulfate in boiling xylene. Palladium carbon can also be used instead of this. There, addition of only one hydrogen will be added, and then you will get the ethylene. So, this is another method of preparation. So, ethylene can be prepared by the addition of hydrogen on alkynes in the presence of Lindler's catalyst. So, what is the Lindler's catalyst means? It is in a palladium. PD means palladium. Palladium. Barium sulfate in boiling xylene. So entirely the role of this, it will add only one mole of hydrogen on alkyne. Further hydrogenation will be stopped. So this is about the preparation of alkynes. So majority of alkynes can be prepared by these three methods. And let's go to the properties of alkynes. All alkynes participate in addition reactions. Because of double bond, alkynes participate in addition reactions. So we know ethylene. The structure of ethylene. This is a sigma bond, this is a sigma bond, sigma bond, sigma bond, sigma bond, and this is a pi bond. Due to the presence of this pi bond, alkenes mainly participate in addition reactions. Alkenes participate in substitution reactions. Alkenes and also alkynes participate in addition reactions. Because the presence of pi bond, due to the presence of pi bond, alkenes participate in addition reaction. Now the length between the carbon and carbon is 1.34 angstroms. The length between the carbon and hydrogen is 1.08 angstroms, and both carbons participate in sp2 hybridization. The shape of the molecule is planar. Bond angle 120 degree. This is the shape of the ethylene molecule. Due to the presence of pi bond, alkenes participate in addition reaction. At the same time, you can take the structural formula of ethene. Ethene contains 5 sigma bonds. See that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Number of sigma bonds? 5. 5 bonds? 1. So the number of sigma and pi bonds in ethylene means we have to say 5 sigma bonds, 1 pi bond. What is the bond length? 1.34. Bond angle 120 degrees. So this is about the structure of ethylene. Now come to the properties of ethylene. The first property, addition of hydrohalogen. Addition of hydrohalogen. Hydrohalogen. What are hydrohalogens? Hydrofluoric acid, hydrochloric acid, hydrobromic acid, hydroiodic acid. All this comes under the hydrohalides. How do they add on alkenes? Let us take a simple example. Ethylene. Addition of hydrochloric acid. It goes ethyl chloride, addition of hydrochloric acid on ethylene. Now ethylene is in a symmetrical alkene, because on double bond both side we have identical groups, so it is said to be symmetrical alkene. Let us take the second example. Now it is an also alkene, but it's a unsymmetrical alkene. It is in a double bond. One side we have a CH2, other side we have an CH3CH. Unsymmetrical alkenes, hydrohalogen. Addition of hydrohalogen on unsymmetrical alkenes may lead two products are possible. One is 1-chloropropene, another is 1-chlorobromine, bromopropene. Second one is 2-bromopropene. Two possibilities are there. On hydrohalogenation of alkenes, unsymmetrical alkenes, there are two possibilities are there. The first one, 1-bromopropene, and second one, 2-bromopropene. So among these two, which is the major product? Means it is a 90%. It is only 10%. If it is unsymmetrical, no problem. You will get only one kind of problem, one kind of product. In the case of unsymmetrical alkynes, there is a propene. Unsymmetrical alkenes, addition of hydrohalogen, we have to get two products, but among them only one is major product. Now how means it follows? It follows Markovnikov rule. While adding the hydrohalogen on unsymmetrical alkene, it follows the Markovnikov rule. So what is the Markovnikov rule means? In the addition of hydrohalogen on unsymmetrical alkenes, the negative part goes to the carbon, which contains less number of hydrogens. Now the same we are taking. See, this is a positive part, this is a negative part. Halide, and it's a negative part. Hydrogen is positive part. Polarized molecule. Now, from the reagent, the negative part, this is a negative part. The negative part goes to the carbon which contains less number of hydrogen. You have seen the double bonded carbons. Among the double bonded carbons, which contains less number of hydrogens. See that this carbon contains two hydrogens and this carbon contains one hydrogen. That's why what happens? The negative part goes to this carbon, not for this carbon. If this goes to this carbon, we are getting this product. But negative part is going to the carbon which contains less number of hydrogen. That's why the major product is two bromopropane. So like this, in the addition of hydrohalogen on unsymmetrical alkanes, they follows the Markovnikov rule. So what is the Markovnikov rule means? In the addition of hydrohalogen or any molecule on unsymmetrical alkenes, the negative part goes to the carbon which contains less number of hydrogens. So you have taken propene in unsymmetrical alkene. The negative part is going to the carbon which contains less number of hydrogens. That's why you are getting 2-bromopropene. The next chemical property. Addition of ozone. Addition of ozone. Because alkenes participate in addition reaction. So the first addition is addition of hydrohalogen. And that follows Markovnikov rule in the addition of unsymmetrical alkenes. Let us take addition of ozone. See, the double bond is completely missing. In the place of double bond, the carbon is getting in a bond with oxygen. And this oxygen is bonding with the carbon. Totally, we are getting an intermediate. It is not a product. So, the name of the intermediate is ethylene ozonide. Ethylene ozonide. When it is subject to the hydrolysis. When it is subject to the hydrolysis. It gives 2 moles of formaldehyde. And hydrogen peroxide. 2 moles of formaldehyde and formaldehyde. So ethylene reacts with the ozone to form ethylene ozonide, which on hydrolysis gives ethylene ozonide, which on hydrolysis gives formaldehyde. Hydrogen peroxide is a byproduct. So like this, we are getting the ethylene ozonide. Addition of ozone on alkenes gives corresponding ozonides, which on hydrolysis gives carbonyl compounds. So the next reaction is addition of, so what is base reagent? Is in a cold alkaline potassium permanganate. So cold alkaline potassium permanganate is in a pink in color, especially used for the detection of pi bonds in the carbon compounds. If the carbon compound contains pi bonds, the pink color will be disappeared. If no pi bonds, color will as it is. So it is in a reagent used for detection of pi bonds, double bond. Now let us take example. Cold alkaline potassium permanganate provides an oxygen, and that oxygen combines with the water and forms two hydroxyls. and forms ethylene glycol. Ethylene glycol is a colorless compound. So all glycols are colorless. So that's why addition of cold alkaline potassium permanganate, the pink color, it is a pink in color. The pink color disappears due to the formation of glycols, dihydroxy compounds or glycols. So like this, important reactions of Calkins we completed. The next another properties we'll discuss in the next class.